Now we have moved away from evening. We are in the very early hours of Sunday. Let me remind you that Ghanaian boxer, the man, the Royal Storm, Isaac Dugwe, will be fighting against Gonzalez in the final eliminator of the WBO featherweight title fight. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have to pray for Emmanuel Otego. We have to pray for Isaac Dugwe. We have to pray for all our boxers who are trying to get back to clinch world title. So now let's get ready for the next bout of the evening. And this is a lightweight contest over six rounds between Loren, Javarez, and Azumah Mohammed. Azumah Mohammed from the Sonia Boxing Foundation and Gymnasium. And few squares, Loren, Javarez. Shall we have the boxes? Azumah Mohammed. So very well. Before Azumah Mohammed, we have the head of security at Ghana Boxing Authority, Dr. Daniel Ayikwe, who has been giving a lot of awards. We would walk through the awards very soon. Now, Ms. Dr. Ayikwe, you welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Now, you were here, you saw what happened. As the head of security for Ghana Boxing Authority, what message do you have for us before the next bout? We are waiting for the boxes.
Well, first of all, I would like to apologize to our viewers and all boxers, for boxing fans, that this unfortunate situation will not occur again. We will make sure the next time we put measures in place to avoid reoccurrence of what happened. So we really want to apologize to all the fans.
Very well. Dr. Daniel Ayikwe, he was given the honorary doctorate degree award by Maverick Institute. He also received Integrated Physical Security of the Year. He also received Responsible Business and Leadership Excellence Award. He also received International Boxing Achievers of the Year. And this is something we have to acknowledge. Shall we put our hands together for Dr. Daniel Ayikwe of the GBA? Next 2 weeks, he's going to tell us more about this award, and we'll continue to actually celebrate you. Now tell us, finally, what message do you have for us ahead of next 2 weeks, night number 10?
Well, we're going to go back to our drawing board and make sure we come back with more security guards. Change the formation that we have here.
Now, there are a lot of fans who visit on the hall. What kind of strategy are you going to adopt in week 10?
Now, in as much as we are having fun, we should also think about safety. So please, I will make quite a fight. You can make a quite a wall, because we go crazy behind it. You have to show it. At the same time, we have to rush to the hospital and all this. So I regret to my guys not to find the wall and not to sit on it. Yo, Charlie, you can't talk to me. So that's it.
Thank you very much, Dr. Daniel Ayikwe. Shall we put hands together for him? He's in charge of security for Ghana Boxing Authority. Now, let's welcome the boxers, Loren Javarez and Azumah Mohammed. The boxer coming is Azumah Mohammed.
Amazing, for you I think I'm going crazy.
So we are ready for the lightweight contest over 6 rounds. Ladies and gentlemen, official for this bout, we have Michael Nikwe, Erasmus Owo, Ami Mensa Kapo, and the 3 judges. Now introducing the boxer fighting out from the blue corner. This evening sported in yellow and red outfit with red socks and yellow gloves to match. With a weight of 134.9 pounds from the Sonia Boxing Gym here in the crowd. This is the boxer with the official record of 5 fights, no defeats, no draw. 3 came by way of knockout. He was born in BUKOM in the Upper East region of Ghana. Presenting to you the boxer, Azumah Mohammed. Switching over to the red corner, a well-known boxer right here at the BUKOM Boxing Arena. One of the best boxers of the Deluxe Professional Boxing League. And this is the man who was born in Dar es Salaam, far away in Tanzania, with an official record of 19 fights, 12 wins, 5 defeats, 2 draws, 7 of the wins. Came by way of knockout with a weight of 135 pounds from the Fifth Square Boxing Gymnasium. Presenting to you the boxer, Loren. Man in charge of this fight is Shadrach Akwey, the technical director of Ghana Boxing Authority.
Well, we've seen a lot of antics from boxers when it comes to major fights, but hardly do we see the introduction of a boxer and then he goes to his opponent's corner to receive the applause. Well, that's exactly what Laura Japhet did as we get ready for the bout. Is scheduled for 6 rounds.
What?
So here we go into the action. Laurent in white, and Azumah Mohammed in the red and yellow trunks.
So Azumah Mohammed, in his last fight, he won against John Amable, who was making his debut. I think he won on points over 6 rounds. And then in his last fight also, Loren Japhet won by a 4th round TKO against Mustafa Ampia right here at the BUKOM Boxing Arena. This fight promises to be a cracker. But one thing, Prince, Loren Japhet, when he fought against Wasiru Mohammed, aka Chatabi, in 2019, right here in Ghana, he fought as a bantamweight. And within a space of 3 years, he has bloated from bantamweight, super bantamweight, featherweight. He's now fighting as a lightweight. I wonder how our boxers are able to keep up with maintaining their weights.
Wow.
In the days of High Court, Azumah Nelson, High Court began his career as a welterweight. He fought as a welterweight until 2002, when he was ready to fight against Fernando Vargas, that he moved to 154, that's Chino middleweight.
Sure.
For Azumah Nelson, he remained a featherweight. He only moved up to challenge Pennell's
Whitaker.
When he was not able to win that fight, he dropped down back to featherweight and continued as a featherweight until he retired.
Yeah.
These days, our bosses are not able to maintain their weight because of maybe lack of training or lack of devotion to their sport.
Mm. Well, I've heard the champ himself speak about the discipline levels of our boxers nowadays. And I think the angle that you just spoke about probably alludes to the fact that they may not be taking them good care of themselves very well. And of course, don't also forget that you don't have a lot of bouts coming up. It's just about training, and it doesn't necessarily make you any slimmer or any lighter. You need to get yourself into the action itself. Thankfully, the Deluxe Professional Boxing League has come up and is giving the boxers the opportunity to showcase exactly what they have. again, we have boxers who have left their countries of origin to come to Ghana to see whether they can hone the skills, sharpen the skills that they have. And Loren Japhet is not the only one. We have many boxers, especially from across our borders, Nigeria, Benin, Togo, who have benefited from the kind of training that is given to them here.
Boxers like Charles Lesbosaya, Adam Habdin, Selano, and a host of others. Yeah.
First round, is there anything to take?
Well, Prince, you could see that both fighters are sizing each other very, very, very well. But when you look at Loren Japhet, you could see that his lead foot is something that we should be watchful of. He always plants his lead foot at the back of Azumah Mohammed's foot, and that is giving him the edge to be able to disengage Azumah Mohammed's punches. And that is something, if you're a boxer and your footwork is that good, you give your opponent a lot of trouble. You can see that Azumah is trying to download his punches, but at the moment Loren plants his foot outside his foot and disengages his punches, then Mohammed goes back to his shelf and try to reignite his punches again.
Yeah.
And that is really, really watchful, and that is something we should be watchful of.
Azumah Mohammed opening up with a flurry of punches, especially in the second round, as he tries to catch. Oh, and he goes down. Trying to catch Loren Japhet. And he acknowledges he took a wrong step.
And you see, Prince, that's what I was talking about. Loren's footwork. He times Azumah Mohammed. Then what he has to do is just plant his leg behind his foot, then just disengage the punch he is bringing on him, then he turns into a counter punch. And that's what we witness.
One amazing thing about Japhet is that although he moved from a lower weight, he has been able to
he's rocked Azumah Mohammed again.
He has been able to carry his power from the lower weight even up to the lightweight division.
Okay.
Not many boxers are able to carry their power to a different weight. Yeah.
So again, those are the disciplinary levels of the average Ghanaian boxer we're talking about. Indeed, some of them are very conscious of, you know, little things like their weight, what they eat, and, you know, ostensibly to keep themselves fit and firm. This is about in the lightweight category. You can see that both boxers have kept their body shape pretty much intact. Oh, and he goes down again, but that will be ruled out. That will be ruled out. And once again, he signals to the corner that he's okay. Loren Japhet also goes down. Yeah, and I think he's getting the mandatory 8 simply because his gloves touch the canvas. Once it does that, you get the 8. So seasoned referee Shadrach Akwe was spot on.
Prince, his glove touched, but it was not by a punch. He went to throw a punch and then he missed.
He missed?
Yeah,
and then went down, yes.
So there is no need for him to be counted.
Well, if you've got seasoned referees as Shadrach Akwe, I'm sure we'll probably get to do a little bit of learning with this, so we can abreast ourselves what is happening.
You get counted when it is by a punch. That is when it's a knockdown. When you go down on your own, it's not a knockdown.
So why was he given the mandatory 8? And we've got a lot of officials who are sitting there, and none of them challenge Shadrach Akwe in this regard. But again, like I said, we will take the opportunity to do a bit more learning. But from what I know, Cecil, come in here and help me out on this. Glove touch the canvas. Does it not deserve, or does it not warrant a mandatory 8?
I mean, if really
we should have a mandatory replay just to see, then we can know from the angle at which referee Richard Akwe had just allowed the mandatory 8 counts. But okay, if it's not from a punch, then that thing doesn't hold. And okay, definitely it will never hold ground within the okay judges count.
Okay,
but if it's a punch that made him go, then definitely he stands out tall.
All right, so an opportunity to learn and pick up on the rules and regulations of Ghana boxing. Third round. And I'm sure that was the reason why we had the surprise look on Laura Japhet's face.
And also, if a boxer, whilst they are in action, a boxer moves backwards, he retreats and then goes on a knee, that boxer can also be counted.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think we saw a little bit of that the previous fight
between Ahmed Abel Nikem and exactly Frank Juan Vogue.
Exactly. Spot on there. Thank you very much for the education, Sam. And Laurent Japhet will still continue to power pressure on Azumah Mohammed. Azumah Mohammed has gone down twice. The first one, he got the 8 count. Second one was judged as a slip. Laurent Japhet has been around for a while, and it looks like he's pretty much polished his act as a boxer.
Yeah, when he came to Ghana, and then he's now being trained by the former trainer of Wasiru Mohammed, the president of Kozlati Kwelati, the Black Bombers. He now trains out of the Fisher Boxing Gym, and is currently managed by a board member of the GBA, Mr. John Mafo.
Seems to be in pretty good hands, Laurent Japhet. He's looked solid, he's looked strong in this bout. And Azumah Mohammed trapping the arm of Laurent Japhet. Bout will continue in earnest, and the delivery there. And then the predating skills of Azumah Mohammed will be brought into full effect. But Laurent Japhet again waiting for that guard which goes down pretty often. Azumah Mohammed's guard.
And Azumah is now taking full advantage of his size difference. He's not allowing Japhet to come close. He's just standing back and throwing those stiff jabs. In his bout against of his Minson, Japhet went into a banger. It was an all-out brawl, and Japhet came out tops. With Elvis Mensah proving to be a tough customer on that night.
Saved by the bell. End of the round.
Well, Prince, I feel as the round goes on, it's all about time and game that both fighters are delivering here tonight. But when you look at Laurent Japhet, as I said earlier on, he's relying on his footwork, and his footwork is doing the job. And I'm still here figuring out why Azumah Mohammed and his corner have not figured out that, you know, this guy is using his footwork to beat us. Just watch here. He tanks him. He makes him fall for the bait, then he tanks him with a punch. And that is what Azumah Mohammed should be watchful on. Because now, as it stands now, it's a timing game both fighters are delivering here. But when you do look at Azumah Mohammed, his punches are not really accurate and significant enough. It's not really backing Loren up. But for Loren, the moment he throws, it has a significant and I feel Azumah Mohammed should get up, because we are getting into the round 4 and he's losing on the scorecards.
Both boxers would have to pick up, but especially from this round, because we've got 2 more rounds to go to bring the bout to an end. quick caution offered by or given by Shadrach Akwe to Loren Japhet. Oh, that's a solid one. Azumah Mohammed still on his feet. He goes in for the clinch. I'm sure he was rocked by that.
And Japhet believes so much in his power. He's not afraid to go into a throwdown. And Prince, the haircut of Azumah Mohammed just caught my eye. I don't know what name that star is called. You have any ideas?
Yeah, well, we'll have to do a little bit of research on that.
I feel maybe this is going to be
a haircut of haircut. Well, for a second, I thought he was even a recruit.
Or security services.
Probably.
Okay.
Oh, that's some solid punches there from Loren Japhet. Again, Sam spoke about this just a couple of seconds ago. His power is the punches that he delivers. Azumah tries to walk in, but Japhet would not stay in one place, would he? It's another caution to the Tanzanian, and that's a big one. Azumah Mohammed has been at the receiving end of some hefty punches from his opponent. Wild miss there from Laurent, and another miss from Azumah. He goes down, but this is ruled out as a no knockdown. Looks like the canvas has become a bit slippery. We saw a slip there from Japhet. So end of the round again, both boxers trying to, as it were, stay on top of the game. And again, I think that Laura has displayed quite well in this round.
Yes, yes, Prince, I agree with that. And he's dictating the pace of the fight. You know, I was expecting that Azumah Mohammed, after he got knocked down, he should just recover himself up and gear himself up and make sure he brings the fight to Japhet. But as it stands now, Japhet is still leading and he is the big fight. And I'm here just thinking and knocking my head how Azumah is going to surpass the rest of the round. But as it stands now, with knockdown rule in favor of Japhet, Japhet will be the one leading. But let's see, we have a couple of rounds to go. Let's see if Azumah also do something in a couple of the rounds left.
Both boxers look fresh as we go into the fifth round. So they've got 6 minutes to showcase that. Oh, goes down once again. I think there's a third time he's gone down with no count being given. But 6 rounds to show exactly what they have left in store to attract the points from the judges. Into a clinch they go.
It's quite obvious that Azumah Mohammed is getting fatigued. So at this point, it will be prudent for Japhet to take his time and pick him apart and not just rush into slugging it out.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. Japhet obviously has shown that he's the steadier boxer. That is of the two boxers. big one to the head of Japhet. That will not rock him. Got to the face of Japhet and trying to follow up. He goes in. Yet another slip.
You know, Prince, I feel a bit worried for Azumah Mohammed. You know, if Japhet is really, really smart enough, he has been throwing, Azumah has been throwing so wild. And if Loren Japhet has been smart enough, he would have counted Azumah Mohammed on numerous, numerous times, because Azumah is throwing so wild. And it's up to Loren Japhet to really time him and counter him. And if he gets that counter clean, Azumah will hit the canvas again.
Couple of punches to the head of Azumah. Wow, that was a wild miss. Japhet going down a second time. We've not seen a lot of in-house kind of fighting from these two boxers, showing each other a lot of respect. But the power behind those swings of Laurent Japhet, he's missed a couple of wild punches. Can't imagine if they had landed. Obviously would have rocked Azumah Mohammed. It's a big one to the head of Laurent. Goes in for the clinch once again. Clearly, from the last couple of seconds, Sam, I would want to tend to agree with you that Azumah Mohammed is gasping for breath.
Azumah is fatigued, but so is Loren at this point. Loren at this point is also fatigued, so he is not able to press the action. I believe that both boxers have questions to answer concerning their conditioning. For the verdict, I think that at this point it should tilt a bit towards Loren, because in the first two rounds, in the first round, Azumah went down. In round two, Loren was counted for what seemed like a slip, but was counted for a knockdown. So those two rounds are even. So right now, with the another three rounds, I think Loren is in front right now. If he's able to maintain that momentum, he should win this fight on point.
Well, the boxer should get ready for what would be the last opportunity to impress the judges. They've got 3 minutes to do so. Quick give and take on that occasion as they open the floodgates for a couple of more punches. And that's a big one on Japhet. Landed straight on the face. Azumah Mohammed letting the guard down a bit too many times.
And you see, Prince, you know, you made mention of he letting his guard down. I see what he's trying to do. He's trying to bait Loren Japhet to come into that square so that he can also get him. But I'm sitting here doubting if he has that kind of mechanism to do that, because that kind of mechanism has to do with the pull counter game.
Sure.
And Floyd Mayweather knows how to do that. Yeah, he's a master in that kind of pull counter game. But if Azumah Mohammed can do that, then we can see something that we've not seen since they started the fight. But let's see what happens.
He would require a lot of strength to handle such a situation, but it looks like tiring legs out there. Loren goes in trying to get the big one with the left. Keeps the jab coming in with the right hand. Oh, that's a solid one, and that Japhet had to go back to maintain his stability. Getting tough by the seconds. We're gradually getting to the end of this bout. It's been a very tough give and take affair.
Clash of heads.
Yeah. And Azumah is rocked once, rocked twice. Quickly goes in for the clinch. Seems to have a cut. Or is it? Yes, he wipes off the blood with his glove. But obviously this should bring us to the end of the bout. But both corners believe that they've done a very good job.
Yeah, the fight was keenly contested to the right to the end, and for me, for my money, I think Loren takes this one out. Azumah put up a spirited effort, but by clean punching and effective aggression, Loren makes it for me.
We are pricing up for the final bout of the evening, and this is the National Lightweight Championship.
As to whether he will continue to campaign in the lightweight category or he will step down is a question to be answered.
Well, we await the verdict from our ring announcer, Mohammed Amin Lamte. Yes, I did say that the haircut looked as if it was, you know, like a recruit. And I just saw the Ghana Prison Service flag right behind him. There you go. There you go. So a proud member of the Ghana Prison Service, showing his class, showing his skill here. Azumah Mohammed.
And the prison service should be proud of him. He has not let them down at all.
Certainly.
He has given his all in the ring.
Certainly.
Win, lose or draw, he should hold his head up high.
But prior to this bout, I think we've also had another service.
Yeah, that is a senior award that they Musa Rahman lost.
Yeah.
He's also in the prison service.
In the prison service. Yeah. So the prison service producing some very good boxers.
Yeah, they also have another super lightweight in the person of Emmanuel Adeayi.
And the likes of Azumah Nelson and Bo will not have been put to shame, not at all. Well, that's the future sensation. They make the future of boxing look bright. We'll talk about that in a second. But over to Amin Lamte.
Judge 2 scored about 58-56. Judge 3 scored about 59-56. By a unanimous point decision, the winner is Darren. There's welcome, the boxer from Dar es Salaam, Tanzania, Japhet.
And so Japhet wins this bout.
For the
big shock on the face of Azumah Mohammed. But I think Loren deserves it.
Oh yes, he deserves it, because you could see, in as much as the fight was a cagey one, but as we keep saying, the knockdown rule, I mean, Loren Japhet did enough. His punches were more significant as compared to Azumah Mohammed. Azumah Mohammed was throwing, but his punches was not really worrying Loren. But I mean, Loren did what he had to do, and congratulations to him.
also impressed, and I thank to my manager because I saw him is around. And I thank to all my team you see here, you know. And I thank for everyone in the building.
Now, people watching you from Tanzania, Dar es Salaam, what message do you have for them?
The message I have is, this is not my life, you know. This is like the way. I'm still working, and I'm still in Ghana.
Thank you very much for coming. So we are waiting for the boxes.